But she will not be your third.
You can't tell me what to do, Nampa. I'll spare you myself.
We were only alone. Because we had to flee the foreigners, trying to kill us!
You're lying. If they wanted to kill you, why didn't they just do it when you're up in the would-be? You don't seem hurt, and neither does Gamade.
You think me a liar? Then where has been talking?
She probably just took her trail. You ran away from Gamade.
Do you remember all the times when the foreigners killed us? Yes! They took some of our own people!
Make them work on the gum trees! Foreigners eat human flesh! That's why they have such light skin! They have that terrible little house from which you hear those terrible little noises. Blood seeps from under the board walls in that terrible house. Let's not be angry with each other. If we're going to spear, let's kill the foreigners!
Yeah!
Didn't we eat their sweet food and drink their drink? Had they not given us many presents that we all have seen very well? Did I not sleep by their warm fire with warm cloth they gave me? Now, why are you going to spear them for no reason?
Because they are foreigners. They need to be killed before they kill us.
Yes.
Let's drink and make our plans. And with these spears, they will fall.
Yeah! You women, go upriver, act as a decoy to separate the five foreigners. I will spear each of the three big men first, while you younger ones finish them off. You, charge them on the beach!
Thank you. Welcome home. Welcome home. Welcome home, son.
As you know. No. No word, Mary Lou. We'll also be standing by. Over. This is the first time since Nate started jungle flying in 1948 that we've been out of contact with each other for even 1 hour, Olive.
It's inconceivable that all five men would forget to call. Maybe their radio isn't functioning.
Maybe. I'm going to call another MAF pilot and have them bring Betty from Shandia and Barbara and Mary Lou from Arizuno. Shelmera to Javaro. Frank, something has happened to our husbands. They are down in Aka territory and they had good contacts. They were supposed to call us, but they didn't. Frank, can you have Johnny Keegan fly over and have a look? Over.
Of course, Marge. Going down now. Over.
Five men are missing in Aka territory. Their plane, PA-14, has been found on the beach. All the fabric is stripped off. There is no sign of the fellows. A ground search party is being organized, and Frank Drown, a man with 12 years of jungle experience, was elected to lead the party. All possible forces which might contribute to their rescue, including prayers from thousands of people in all parts of the world, are set in motion.
Barbara, Mary Lou, Betty, oh, they found one body. Shelmera standing by, Frank.
Shelmera, another body sighted, 200 feet below Palm Beach.
Grace is sufficient.
As the world hopes and prays and waits, the procession of flying machines, the little yellow Piper flying the lowest, the U.S. Navy R-4D higher, and the Air Rescue Service higher yet, the Ecuadorian Air Force flies in wide circles ready to help. The teamwork of the United States Army, Air Force, Navy, and that of the government and military services of Ecuador stand ready to assist.
Now we wait. Frank.
Please, don't try to solve the problem. We want to know every detail. What did you find?
We found four bodies in the river. One was caught under the branches of a tree that had fallen down. One had on a red belt of some kind of woven material.
That was me.
Another one had on a t-shirt and blue jeans.
Rancho's holy water.
Barbara. What about Nate?
Nate had his wristwatch around his arm like he always does when he's trying to remember something. He had a spear in his head and a machete in his face. Here are some wedding rings and watches and things that we found along the beach. All five are dead. A huge tropical storm was rumbling. Everybody had their finger on the trigger, pointing toward the jungle, expecting more orcas to come. The rain was coming down in buckets. And we fought and struggled with a muddy bank to try and carry him to a common grave. I had a short service and offered some words of prayer. And we looked at our friends and finally got over my feeling of heading to touch their bodies. Because a body's just a house. These fellows had left their house. And once the soul leaves the body, it's really not much. The thing that's beautiful to us is their soul, not their body.
God gave me this verse 2 days ago. Psalms 48:14. For this God is our God forever and ever. He will be our guide even unto death. My heart is filled with praise. Raj was worthy of his homegoing. Help me, Lord, to be both mommy and daddy. I want to be free of self-pity. It is a tool of Satan to rot away a life. I am sure that this is the perfect will of God.
Ladies, somehow God's closed your hearts to grief and hysteria. And he's filled it in with his perfect peace. Should we schedule tickets to take you back to the States as soon as possible?
I'm staying. God didn't call just Jim to Ecuador. It was my calling too. The fact that Jesus Christ loved and died for all makes me interested in the salvation of all. But the fact that Jim loved and died for the Ocas, that just intensifies my love for them.
That's true. And I will go back to the States to have Ed's third child, but then I'll return here to Ecuador to continue work in Quito at missionary headquarters.
I will also take my three children to help you, Mary Lou, at Quito as well.
My two children and I will go with you and Marie Frank to work with the Indians.
None of you seek any vengeance or harbor any bitterness.
Vengeance? Bitterness? This is God's perfect plan. We have no regrets.
Valerie and I will continue work with the Quechuas at Shandia, and then we will try and make contact with the Ocas.
Darkness around me, sorrow surrounds me, though there be trials, still I can sing, for I have this treasure, my God reigns within me, and I am determined to
I'm so sorry. I have to return. I have to return to my people and show them that not all foreigners kill. Will you come with me?
Take you into our territory. Come home, daughter.
I will. I will come home, and I will bring my friends with me. Will you return with me back home?
This is what I'm thankful.
Thank you.
You look like Dayuma. But you died in that forest. You don't fool me. You're a spirit.
You look like a man. But you don't fool me. You're Minkaye. You hid me in the forest, Minkaye. When I ran to the foreigners, they let me live.
No. Your spirit!
What are they doing, Mommy?
Don't worry, honey. They're just playing a game to see who can touch the most.
I don't like this. I don't like this at all! When would the would-be family come back and attack us?
They won't attack us! Can't you see that I am well? I've lived with them! The would-be family wanted to tell you that Wangongi doesn't want anyone to kill.
Wangongi? How do they know what Wangongi says?
They have his carvings. They say we shouldn't kill.
Where are these carvings? Show them to us.
The would-be family can show you. Will you let them live with you?
We spared their family, and they want to stay with us? We are their enemies. They can stay if they choose. Mikaye, if they cause trouble, you spear them.
Or, I say we spear them now!
They're just women. Tell me, why haven't the would-be men tried to kill us yet?
They wanted to tell you that Wangongi had a son. He was speared, but he didn't spear back, so that the people spearing him might one day live well.
I'm going to tell the community that you are with us. But you have to have names like us. May we call you Nemo after Dayumi's sister who was murdered.
I am honored to bear the name Nemo.
And you, we will call you Jakari.
If she doesn't mind being called Woodpecker.
Come. Come see the pale people who have told us about Wangongi.
Who cares for Wangongi?
I do.
What is wrong with Nemo? It's like he's weak and lost all will. Listen to the foreigners. Kima, why are you so taken with what they're saying?
Nampa, Takeda, Mankei, all of you. You were there at the spearing.
You saw the spirits carry them across the great boa. They speak the truth. They know what they're talking about. I believe them. So does Dawa.
It's true. I want to live without hating and killing.
You were with us when we killed their family.
I'm sorry for that. We lived without understanding, but now we understand.
If you'll be allowed to stay,
could you bring the house for us?
Yes, come.
Kimo, if you build that house, it'll be your grave.
Don't worry, he's like a chihuahua. Yep, yep, yep.
Get away from my sister!
Or what?
Bring me the children. Throw them in here with me so I can cross the great boa.
You know what happens? He will stay alive with me. Tommy and Dan find the key.
You crazy?
You can't have him.
What are you
gonna do? No!
Go! Now! Go!
Are you want me to die alone?
Gather round, everyone. It's Sunday morning. Time for Bible teaching.
Whatever Sunday is, you did not learn it from here, Dayuma. Every day is the same to us. We get up, eat our fish, drink our manioc, go hunting for pigs, deer, monkey, macaws, toucans, everything to feed our families. We now have such a large community to feed. So many of our men have fallen to the spear that now we have to feed their families too.
Kakita, that is true. But we want to take time to learn about Wayangongi and how to follow his trail.
How do we follow this Wayangongi trail? Is it like our children follow the markings so they can find us again? No one has ever showed us this kind of trail.
Well, you know that Wayangongi created everything.
Yes, we know that.
Well, Wayangongi sent his only son down, dripping with blood, to mark the trail. And then Father Creator used that very same blood to wash our hearts clean. Clean as a sky without a cloud in it. So then we can see the trail. And in God's place, the trail is like gold.
Nemo, can Wayangongi make even me clean?
Minkai, Wayangongi created everything. He's all powerful. Of course he can make your heart clean too.
Oh, my family, look who's arrived. Everyone, this is Marge and Stevie, her son. Her husband, the yellow
Stevie. Wimpy. It is so good to see you. Look how big you've grown.
Marge.
Rachel! So good to see you.
How are you then?
Very well. And you?
Good, good. Do you think that Stevie could stay and live here with me among the people? Now that they've given up their vendettas, they can truly understand that we have no vendetta.
Well, he has really been missing his daddy lately. Maybe a visit with Aunt Rachel would be just what he needs. Stevie boy, would you like that?
Yes, ma'am, I would love it.
All right, then it's settled.
Can I really, Aunt Rachel?
Yes.
Well, I mean, you don't think they will think I'm here to avenge my dad's death, since that is the way they do it.
No, Stevie. You see, Dayuma and I have been studying together for so long, and I teach her God's ways, and she teaches the people, and they listen to her, and they truly understand. In fact, now, They're no longer even called Aka, which was a slang name meaning naked savage. They now go by their true given name, the Wadani.
They tell us about God, and they also tell us that there's another world out there.
There will be no more fighting. It is all we've known since before Nemo and Jakari came to stay with us. I myself witnessed my parents murdered when I was a small child.
And my dad, who was cut up into pieces by a machete.
And I got my wife, Oppenday, from the spearing raids. We'd kill the men, and we'd take the women for our wives. That's how Kimo got Dawa also.
The ones that killed your father and his friends, Babe, are the same ones that speared my brothers.
We put one, two, even three spears into each person. Everyone a spear for no reason. Blood feuds all the time. It's a wonder there are any of us left.
So you can see, Stevie, everyone here has lost someone that they love to the spear.
Well then, I'm no different from them. We've all lost family members to the spear.
And I can tell. Wangange has started making me clean so I can walk his trail. Why would I walk my own trail and there's nothing waiting for me at the end?
I believe Jesus is calling me too.
I may be young, but I'm old enough to see. The people around me going round in circles with nowhere else to go, looking for some answers to questions they don't know. I know someone real who satisfies the emptiness they try so hard to hide. Jesus says, come, take water for your thirsty soul. I know you've lost your way,
cast away.
I can make your life whole. Jesus says, come, my grace will lift you up. My love can drown your fear. My arms will hold you safe. Jesus says, come.
The Lord is good and he always does what's right. He said his yoke is easy and his burden is light. Cast your care on Jesus, for it is he who cares for you. Rest and peace will comfort all the night through.